and I made a leather mask.
It's so cool.
As part of our steampunk Justice League, I'm making my husband a steampunk Green Lantern costume. I wanted to start with something simple just to kind of dip my toes into the costume, so I started with the mask. And it's turning out to be a little more simple than I actually ever kind of dreamed of. First up, I made my concept sketches. And so I have a few ideas on what I want to do, but the shape is relatively the same in all of them. Next, I took some cardstock and I folded it in half. I guess they call this the hamburger fold. And then I put it up to my husband's face because it's gonna go on his face and not mine. The fold goes in the middle of the nose. I kind of sketched where the eyeball goes and kind of how high, how low, and how far to the side I want the mask to go. I really hope that made some sense. And then I cut it out. So it looked like that, and it was symmetrical. And then I got some tooling leather at the craft store. I got the one that is 4 to 5 ounces, which means that's how thick it is. How much is that? Like a millimeter or something? And then I took my template and I traced it to the back of the leather. And then I used my expo knife to cut it all out, which actually sounds harder than it was. No, it's harder than it sounds. One, because of the thickness, and two, I don't know, I was having problems. It was rough. So once I cut the template out, I took the leather and I soaked it in some warm water for about 2 minutes. Once you put the leather into the water, bubbles will start forming on the leather. Just wait until the bubbles kind of go away, or if you think it's been in there a while and the bubbles haven't, just kind of shake it around, let it sit a little longer, and you're good. I used a craft mask to help mold the leather because I could just kind of let the leather sit on top and dry and form to it, and I didn't have to basically spend his time letting leather dry to his face. That sounds disgusting. And then this is what I got. My next step, I need to dye this green. So I'm gonna look for some leather dye. Do you know of any good leather dye out there? Like, what can I use? Can I just use Rit dye and just like wipe it on there? Probably, I don't know. I really want this mask to just kind of float there. So I'm trying to think of how to attach it to the face without using string. And some people have suggested like medical adhesive. And so maybe that would work. In just a minute, I'll comment on some of your comments, but if you haven't already, subscribe to the Weird Girls YouTube channel, where you can see more of my cosplay videos, Danny Danger and her comic books, Jen Amanda talking about Disney and Star Wars, and Mark talking about everything else in between. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and leave me some love in the comments below! In the video before, when I was going over my concept for Steampunk Zatanna and Steampunk Green Lantern, Cassandra suggested taking a look at Simplicity Pattern 2525, maybe adding a Victorian bustle or something to Steampunk Zatanna, and I think it's a brilliant idea. So I am completely scrapping what I had before, and I'm looking at more Victorian patterns. I'm taking my time with this one. I think I'm gonna start her after I completely finish Green Lantern, because I have so many ideas going through my brain. Oh my god! So thank you so much, Cassandra. I really appreciate your input. I'm so excited. I just, so many ideas! So many of you commented about what I meant for Steampunk Green Lantern's jacket. William Bryan suggested maybe the Rocketeer's jacket. Nathan suggested a cross between Picard's jacket when Worf got the promotion and Guy Gardner's suit. Fairlady's D2005 suggested maybe a modern navy military jacket, and the answer is yes to all of the above. And because you guys gave me such great ideas and such a great jumping off point, I actually was able to find a pattern that I can really manipulate pretty easily. It's McCall's 4745. It's a military jacket! So this one I'll have to modify just a little bit. Of course, the length I'll probably have to modify. We want it to be a vest, so instead of being a jacket, it'll be a vest. And the buttons kind of go in a V, which is kind of weird, so I'm just gonna have to rearrange them to where they go parallel straight down. I'm really excited. I think it's gonna work out. I think it's gonna work out. So I just need to make him a dress form so I can properly go ahead and alter this pattern. Hopefully it'll work out, and we'll probably have a jacket here in a couple weeks, if I can find the fabric. Forgot about that part. Thank you to everyone who gave me support and comments and all of these ideas. They're wonderful, and they are really going to make these costumes fantastic.